Come on down, Luke. Well, I've shaved down to where I think there are bones. So I'm expecting the bones to be right back in here.
We've been digging on this site, kept finding odds and ends of it.
A few weeks ago, Clayton's cousin Kelly brought him to a part of his ranch where he discovered several bones to a T-Rex.
This is where she's at, huh?
Yep. Gonna take a lot of digging.
After confirming the site is safely on family land and not government property, Clayton brought in the heavy equipment to clear over 30 feet of overburden, covering the bone layer.
Definitely a concern, putting a lot of effort and money into this site already. If it don't pan out, it's gonna be expensive. Big gamble for nothing.
Only a dozen or so complete T-Rex skeletons have been found since 1902, when fossil hunter Barnum Brown found the first full specimen in Montana. A similar find today could bring in millions for Clayton and his team, recouping their investment in the site while providing a hefty profit.
Life's a gamble, we're gonna go for it. So I'm gonna start shaving, just half inch at a time till we get down a little lower, and you can let me know if you see something. If we don't hit some bones out in here, I'm going to get nervous. Just keep your eyes open.
Sounds good.
With the overburden removed, Clayton needs to pinpoint the bone layer by carefully shaving with the skid steer.
I'll have Luke spotting for any change of color to indicate that there could possibly be the tip of a bone. If we find one bone, then obviously we shut the machine off and we start working around it by hand. If we can get one bone today, I'll be just tickled pink because that'll tell me that we're not wasting our time.
We have a visual on a potential bone.
Check her out.
It's just mud.
Don't hurt to check. You see that color change in the matrix? Starting to go to a little more sandy colored. Yeah, I think we're darn sure close to the bone zone. I have a gut feeling that we're gonna get something out of this hill. We're gonna see what we come up with. There's a good chance we're gonna find more of it. Well, yeah, I think it is. And I'm pretty sure it's Rex bone. Just a little fragment of Rex bone. It just has a little bit of honeycomb in it.
T-Rex bones stand out thanks to their signature honeycomb-like internal structure. The porous bones made their skeletons lighter, which made these predators faster, with juveniles reaching speeds of 33 miles per hour, allowing them to chase down their prey.
Let's just ease around it and see if you can find another bone in there. Well, I hope there's more than that of this critter in this hill, Luke.
There will be.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh my.
Definitely a bone. Yeah. Looks like a little cervical rib or something maybe, but boy, it's too early to tell. Maybe a little gastralia or something too.
Gastralia are free-floating bones located in the abdominal area that are also present in modern-day crocodilians.
I'd much rather have seen that be an eye socket and turn into a skull right there. But at least we found the lair, and that's what I wanted to do today. I think we're on him. If there's any potential for this Tyrannosaur to be in the hill, we're gonna find more of it. Well, it's a gamble, and we're gonna take it and see what we come up with. Let's go after it. I definitely expect to see something very soon.
After investing a lot of money to remove 30 feet of overburden, Clayton and Luke successfully pinpointed the bone layer at their T-Rex site. Now the guys are expanding their search by shaving more of the site down to the target layer.
Hey, stop, there's something right here.
What do you got?
I don't know, it's a bone. It looks like you just nicked the corner of it. Didn't hit it bad, though.
That didn't take long. What do you think it is?
It's tough to say at this point. We'll have to...
Well, let's perimeter it and see if we can figure it out. Looks like it keeps going. You work down that side.
I think it's Rex or not?
It looks, I mean, that has a texture of a Rex bone. I mean, it's a limb bone, we see that. It looks like a metatarsal. Yeah, I think that's a metatarsal.
The metatarsal is one of three large foot bones connecting the toes to the ankle. Together, they were responsible for holding up and balancing up to 8 tons of T-Rex.
This would be the end pointing towards his claws. And this would be the end pointing towards his knee. Maybe we'll have a big foot with some claws in here. Geez, that's awesome.
What, 24 inches?
Well, that's a full-grown T-Rex. Imagine how big that foot was.
Though its footprints were smaller because it walked on its toes, the foot of an adult T-Rex was over 3 feet long. These massive feet propelled the animal with strides up to 15 feet.
I've only ever seen a couple of these.
I don't think I've ever seen one.
It's an extremely hard to find bone, yeah. Geez, you just don't get a big metatarsal like that every day from a T-Rex, and condition looks spectacular. Good job, Luke, your first metatarsal. Sweet.
Yeah,
I'm pretty pumped now. Guess first thing we better do is map it, and then we'll grab some jacketing stuff and get it pulled out of here and see if there's anything else around it. We're gonna jacket it and get it out of the hills and take it to the lab. Katie and Chris, they're gonna be stoked to get this one in there. It's gonna prep out beautiful. And once we get that done, we'll come back and, holy cow, I can't wait. There's gotta be more of this guy in the hill. We just spent a lot of diesel smoke and frustration and haven't found much. Chris called and said this T-Rex has been scavenged, maybe by another T-Rex or a Nanotyrannus or some other critter. So the bones could be scattered out over a quarter mile flat. The bones could be scattered widely. But we've got a lot of money already invested in this site. So hopefully today will be a turning point for us and we'll actually hit another bone pocket and it'll pick up and we can actually recover a little bit of that.
Dumping more money into a dinosaur that's been scavenged is a gamble. So Clayton's called in the CK preparations team to help make one final assessment of the site.
Howdy, Clayton.
Good timing. Need some spotters. We haven't hit anything yet, so maybe you guys will bring some luck.
There's enough room there on the corner. There's got some potential, so.
We got another 10 feet to shave this afternoon. And
well, fire her up.
With a T-Rex, that's the cream of the crop. So if you want to make the most bang for your buck in work, you go after a Rex. That's why we dug such a big hole here to really make sure this dinosaur was or wasn't here.
Well, weird color change. Negatory.
The Hell Creek Formation is very unpredictable, and you don't know until you're finished digging and kind of exhausted all options, and a lot of things can happen between when the dinosaur died and digging him up. Man, you can have a lot of time and money into a project that doesn't pan out at all.
With any luck, we'll find some more of him.
Hold up. Looks like it. What do you got?
I don't know. Is it a bug?
Oh, man.
It's looking like the right color.
What do you got?
Yeah.
Oh, babe.
That's exactly what you're after, but it's just really mineralized clay with some plant, but that's the right color and texture.
Good spotting.
It's that color, you know.
Gotta stop.
Yep.
A fossil.
Our plan was to dig on this site and just try to find the source of that theropod, and there's just nothing else there. There's nothing left here for us. Well, guys, all good things must end.
Yep, that looks like the base.
Yeah, it's time to call it.
Sad.
As Chris was prepping the bones that we'd found, he could tell that the animal had been scavenged. And that tells us that, you know, a lot of the skeleton's probably been drug off or eaten. Well, that kind of was a dampener, but this was a bust for us. We got to move on. Yep. It was worth the gamble. Yep. It wasn't for lack of trying.
We have a very short window to find dinosaur bones and to get something out of the ground before snow flies. And it really hurts if we have a bust starting out.
With the failure of the T-Rex dig, Clayton and his team need to cut their losses and turn their attention to finding another promising site.
Well, guys, let's get this equipment loaded up and get out of here.
I got people depending on me, family to feed, bills to pay, and you know, if we don't get a good start, it can get rough from there.
That's the reality of hunting dinosaurs. If it was easy, everybody'd do it.